In this video, I'm going to show you how I went about modeling my own little time-lapse trigger holder for my 3D printer. If you want to learn more about 3D printing layer lapses, go check that out over in the cards or linked down in the description. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. Here we are, starting in a fresh Blender file. We're going to create that little trigger system that I had to hold my trigger release system for doing 3D printing layer time lapses. So I'm going to select everything, delete it, and if you want to do this before, go down into the description. You can see all the dimensions right there and try and give this a go. I'm going to start this off by creating the cutting body of the inside of what my trigger dimensions are. So I'm starting with 40 here, and then I'm actually going to go and use the dimensions here. The X is 22 and the Z doesn't really matter, but I'm going to change this to 20 now. So remember, we've just played around with our scale, so we have to go ahead and apply our scale. I'm then going to do a shifty duplication and I'm going to re-edit these numbers here. So this here should now be 26 by 46. I think, no, by 48, whoops, there we go, 48, and that is about right. Now, this isn't in the right placement, because right here, this is going to be the side that's against my 3D printer, and this side here shows up as 6 millimeters thick. So let's go ahead and deal with that. Now, just for future, I like to keep that on vertex snapping. I'm going to use some CAD transforms here, going to go G, move this on the Y, snap it to here. Normal movement now, G, Y, minus 6, and there we have it. Now we can go ahead and do a minus boolean right there with our bool tool, and we get this lovely shape. Now already, that's almost there. Now there is a little cutaway right here that I'm wanting to do that I haven't done to this cube yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this cutaway cube, I'm going to go ahead and focus the view of it, go into edit mode, I'm going to add a loop cut, I'm going to push that loop cut all the way down. Then I'm going to go G, Z, and bring this up. It looks like it's 13 millimeters. And then I'm going to go ahead and grab this face here and extrude it out. Oops, I got it all. I need just this face. Extrude that face out. Fantastic. Now, what does that exactly do? Well, it does this. If we go out of there, we've now just done that lovely cutaway real quick and easy. Okay, so with that there, now let's go ahead and deal with our holes here on the side. So I'm going to go with my 3D cursor, snap it to that face there, create myself a cylinder, and I like to have a pretty high vertex count for this. So I'm going to change this by times it by 3. My radius, well, I know my diameter. My diameter is 7. So I'm going to go 7 divided by 2 here, and then that's going to do it all for me. The depth doesn't really matter, so I'm just going to go for something nice and high. Let's go for 10. And this does matter. The rotation, I need to change that to 90. Great, so now that is a sort of like our cutting object made. Anyway, the beginning of our cutting object made. Let's go ahead and use our CAD transforms once again. Let's go G, space to cancel all of our snapping, Shift F to go face center snapping, and I'm going from face center to V to a vertex right there. Why is that? Because I have the dimensions that this on the X in this direction is exactly 10 millimeters. So minus 10, and then GZ minus 5.5 is what I decided to go with here. All right, so that's almost there, but as you can see, I have a little smaller hole here, and this should be 1 millimeter sent to the back. Now, before I go ahead and do that, I'm going to go Shift D, right click, G, and I'm going to move this along on the X, and it looks like from the drawing, I've got 12.75 millimeters in the other direction, and I hit enter, and we'll come back to that one later. So from here, I'm going to go Shift D, right click, then I'm going to change the dimensions right here. Now the dimensions that I want to go for is 3.8 in diameter by 3.8. Of course, we've just played around with dimensions, so make sure you apply the scale. Then let's go G, Y, move this out a little bit because it doesn't really matter. But what we're wanting to do is join these two together. So let's go Control Shift Plus. So this is now one entire object. And now let's go G, Y and move this 1 millimeter. So that is more like our drawing. Now there is a hole on the other side of here that is exactly the same. So let's just take this into edit mode. Let's grab this edge loop here, go G, Y and pull that all the way along like that. And in fact, we can now go ahead and do our cut. So let's do that cut then. There we go, we've cut it. That's exactly how it should be. Now we have this lovely thing right here. What I'm gonna do is we're first gonna go ahead and fiddle around with dimensions of this. So the Z of this needs to be set from what I'm seeing to 7.5. So let's go 7.5, fantastic. Then I'm gonna go G, Y, pull that out. And then I'm gonna take a top view look, take this into edit mode, X-ray as well, and then I'm going to select straight down the center like that, and I'm going to delete that half there. So X, delete those vertices. Let's go out of X-ray. Let's join this up here. So F and join that up there. F, then let's select all of that. F, do the same. Let's invert our selection. F, then do an edge loop selection of this F. And then let's extrude this out. Now, the reason why we've done that is because even if we did just go ahead and pulled that out, there would have been a small change. This would have gone just the smallest, tiniest bit shorter. So let's go ahead. Now that that's in place, we can just go ahead and snap this face over to that face. And we've got lovely face snapping with our CAD transforms here. So let's just go face from this face, constrained on the Y, this Y, please, to this face over here. Fantastic. So that's that there. Let's select those two, do a cutaway, and you can see that that's turned out brilliantly. Now, we can see that the scale's a bit off here. So I'm just going to select this, make sure that our, whoops, not saving, our scale is set properly here, and that our scale on this one is also set properly, because we're going to get some problems if not. So now that that has gone ahead and set that scale, actually, I want to show you what problems we're going to get. So let's undo that last fixing of the scale. On purpose, I'm leaving this scale wrong to show you why we want to go ahead and do that. But this here is basically ready to go ahead and do our last little modifications. So the best way that I go about and do that is I go ahead and select everything in the scene, go Shift D, right click, I create a new collection, and I drag what we just copied into that collection. I then call this ref for reference. So if I ever want to go back to it, and then I turn on all my restriction toggles, turn them all off here so that this is sort of like a save, so to speak, of that state. Now I actually go ahead and save my file. You should really save your file beforehand. So if Blender ever does crash, it can sort of recover the file. So let's go ahead and save that now. So file, save as. I'll call this trigger holder. Great. So we've got trigger holder done right there. So trigger holder is now set. I'm going to select this, going to go over to the modifiers. I'm going to apply all of them now because that is perfect. I can now go Control I, invert the selection. You'll see it won't select anything in here. And we can just go ahead and delete that. So now we have this lovely bit of mesh that we've created. So before we go ahead and get any trickier with it, let's take it into edit mode. Let's go vertex selection, select everything, merge by distance to double check that there isn't any weird things happening there. And there isn't. That seems to have turned out quite nicely for us. All right. Well, now let's go ahead, do an X, do a limited dissolve and set this to 0.1. Now that should get rid of a couple of edges, but there's a few edges here that I'm not too happy with. Like I don't really want that edge right there. I don't really want this edge going over there and things like that. So let's go ahead and fix this up. Now the main reason why I'm doing this, and remember I'm doing this with J because that will cut the face itself, is because I want to add a bevel to these corners here. And sometimes it's just best to just keep edges away from those bevels when we're doing this super non-quad geometry. You just want to sort of give it as much room to breathe as possible. So I'm going to go ahead, J on all of those. Then I'm going to select edges that I do not want to deal with. So we're going to, just before I do that one, let's select this one and set that up there. If not, we're going to have some problems with that one as well. And I'll select that one to that one up there. And just double check on this side. That's fine there. And let's do one last check over here. That's good. Okay, so now I'm going to select all of these right here. These are all the ones that I want to sort of just delete, remove. They're adding more pain that I want to have. Now, they're not that annoying, but we're going to do a dissolve edge and see if that screws things up. It does not. It's made this very clean. Oops, forgot to do that one as well. Dissolve that edge. Let's select everything quickly. Do a merge by distance. Double check there's nothing wrong. Okay, now this is the main thing that I wanted to show you. So we know that the scale factor is wrong, and this is what happens in edit mode when your scale factor is wrong and you're trying to do a bevel. You see how this bevel isn't quite right? It's just, this should be a 45 degree and it's not turning out how it should. So that's all to do with your scale factor here. So make sure you go ahead and apply that scale, because now when you'll do your bevel, it will give you more of a 45 degree. Okay, it might be very subtle on this one because it's not that crazy. But anyway, so I'm going to go max here. I'm going to go with a clamp overlap. Brilliant. Do the same with this one here. Go max clamp overlap, select everything, merge by distance, removes all those vertices that were over in the same exact space. And that is basically us sorted. Let's just do a quick little check that all this is looking good. It is. Let's just give this a quick little look with our 3D print toolbox. And it's looking pretty damn good. There's one non-flat face. Let's just take a look at what it is. It's this one over here. I don't think that's going to give us any problem. It's because this is connecting right there. If you wanted to sort that out, all you have to do is reconnect that one up to that vertex up there. And let's see, do we have that same problem on this side? No. So all that's really happening here, and it's actually probably a good thing to just show you how to fix this. Just go ahead, grab these two. We'll select that one. And then we will go, merge and at last. And then once we've done that, we should have a flat face now. Let's see. Check all. That's now a nice flat face. There's a couple of overhangs. That's just letting us know right over here that there are some problems. And there's another way that we could have analyzed the mesh, but I think that's going to be good enough for right this moment. So let's select that. Double check that it's all looking good. It is indeed. Let's export this as an STL now. So file, export, STL. And make sure you go selected only. I'm going to go to my desktop, export that, and I'm going to take it into Prusa and see how that turned out. So here we are in Prusa Slicer, and so far, so good. You can see that it's looking like a very clean mesh here. Yep, let's go ahead and slice this up, see how it's turning out, and it's all looking good. Just be aware that you probably want to paint on some supports right there. You don't really have to matter too much about this right here. If you wanted, you could turn that into a more of a teardrop shape. Let's go ahead, let's pull this down, just double check that the mesh is looking good. It is indeed. Let's get this printed, and then if you want to see it in action, you go check out my other video where I show you how I do my 3D printing time lapses. And there you have it. That's how I went about modeling my own little time-lapse trigger holding system. Now, if you want to see this in action, of course, it's still in the cards or linked down in the description. And remember, the key takeaway from this is that scale is so important, not only just for modifiers, but for beveling too in edit mode, because it just seems to work like a modifier, but within edit mode. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it means so much to have your support. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.